So we have the perimeter all trenched out. Now we'll put plastic down and then rebar, and then we wait. Not today. You can see the clouds coming in a little bit. It's supposed to be better tomorrow or the next day. Hey, so the concrete truck beat us before we've got the tent up, but we're going to make it go. So we're pretty well poured except for this last little bit. This is where you wonder if you've ordered enough concrete. But I think we did. We're good. So you can see we're power screeding now. It just takes all the air bubbles out, gives it that initial smoothing so that the next time we'll come back with a power trowel, and I'll show you how that works. But it basically has a cam in there that's down at the bottom right below the motor. It just spins, it's an oblong cam, so it creates a vibration. This garage is a 24 by 24 cape. We're cutting out the rafters, cutting the bird's mouth in and the tail that hangs out over. Cutting the angle on the other end. We're going to build these or cut these ahead so that we can, when we get on site, we just put them up and away we go. There'll also be a gusset that goes on top on each side, and a collar tie and knee wall. So as you can see, we've kind of laid this out. This represents what the upstairs will be.
We're going to now build these, the two gable end walls. So we'll put that together. It'll be two separate sections that we'll put up there. One section will have the window in it, which is dead center. The other one will not. And then we'll put that together. And it hopefully fits when we get there. I'm going to show you how we mark out the 16 centers. This represents, again, this sitting upstairs on the deck. So this is the very outside of the deck, right here. And we want to pull 16 centers so that it matches downstairs as well. So right there, that represents the edge of the floor. I've already started putting some marks, 16 centers. Go across. Okay. Yeah. Not much holding on there. Let's see, 3/4. You hold back 3/4 of an inch so that you get the 16 right on the center of the mark. We'll transfer these marks onto to the top of the plate when we get to that point. Okay. So there's a window going in here. This is dead center of the building. The window is 3 feet wide, rough opening. So we'll come back 1.5 feet, 18 inches. And there's with a jack stud and a stud. Okay, so then we make mark for cripples. This from here, it actually comes out 16 centers from that point. So we'll go to this side, 1.5 feet, plus a jack, plus a stud. We'll actually nail the window. Let me just drag this over here and show you. For transportation purposes, we'll nail it to this side. It could be either side, but we're going to do this one. We'll nail that. We'll put the cripples in to this point, so it'll stabilize that window for shipping. We'll also put the top plates on. And so this will be one unit. That will be a unit. Sounds easy? Hopefully it is. Okay, first one built, first gable end. We'll pick those two wall sections up and go stack them on the pile and build another one.
Want that end, Joe? I'll take this end, one end. Shouldn't be too bad. Weight-wise. All right, that's right. You want me to pick up the whole thing?
I do, Beth. I do just about have the whole sneaky thing. Pick
up the other half so we can go walk.
Let's get another piece. There you have it. We'll just do the same for the second one. So that's the pile over there. Concrete is done. We're all set. We're stripping the forms now. Going to take down the temporary roof that we put up, that we ended up not using because it didn't rain. The weatherman was wrong. This is the end of part one. Thanks for watching. Hope you'll subscribe and hit that little like button. Thank you.